No-dip vertical jump. Purpose: to remove any excess momentum from an athlete's jump so that only leg power is measured. Equipment needed: Vertec or G-Vert systems. Procedure: the athlete will sit on a chair or a box to ensure their legs are bent at a 90-degree angle. Make sure to scoot all the way back into the seat, or if on a box, that heels are flush with the box and ground. Maintain knees at a 90-degree angle. Extend both hands above shoulders, then bend at the hips to form a 45-degree angle. When jumping, the athlete should aim to touch the highest point on the vertec, or if on the G-vert, simply jump as high as possible into the air. If on the vertec, the athlete may extend only their dominant hand to touch the vertec measuring tool. At this point, the athlete will jump without allowing their torso or arms to shift forward. This is to limit the excess momentum moving the body creates. Foot speed. Purpose: test how fast the brain is sending signals to the muscles. Equipment required: a countdown timer and a speed ladder. Procedure: with the speed ladder on the ground, the athlete takes position with one foot in a box and the other foot outside the speed ladder. The athlete is to move in and out of the box as fast as they possibly can in 10 seconds. The trainer should have a countdown timer set to 10 seconds. Having a countdown timer allows the trainer to count the athlete's foot touches rather than needing to pay attention to the timer. Every 2 foot touches counts as 1 rep. The trainer stops counting as soon as the timer beeps. On the athlete's first movement, the timer begins. Vert jump. Purpose: to test the vertical jump height. Equipment needed: vertical jump measuring device, a long pole to move the measure bars out of the way, and the formula for peak leg power. Procedure: have the athlete stand on the side of the rack appropriate for their dominant hand. Have them reach as high as possible with their dominant hand, with their feet flat on the ground. Bring the rack within their reach. The athlete will then jump 3 times and rest 15 seconds between each jump. The trainer will only take the athlete's best jump score. To begin the jump, the athlete will bring their arms back and get into a semi-crouch or squat-like position. However, don't allow them to bend their knees past a 90-degree angle. Have them pause at the bottom. No counter movement is allowed, such as arm swing or anything that will increase their momentum. With all this in place, the athlete will jump to reach as high as possible. After the first jump, move the swatted bars out of the way. When the athlete is ready, have them jump a second time. If they manage to jump higher than the first jump, move the swatted bars out of the way and have them repeat a 3rd and final time. You will only take their highest jump height. Reactive strength test. Purpose: a test to monitor the acceleration, agility, and the athlete's ability to change direction. Equipment needed: push band, along with a companion phone app. Procedure: when doing this procedure, the athlete should ensure that they keep the amount of time between jumps when touching the floor as short as possible. To begin, the athlete should stand with their hands on their hips and then jump as fast as they can, 2 times in a row.